I didn't climb.
Thank you.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the cortege of professors. Before I start, may I ask everyone to switch off their mobile phone, please? This might take a while. honored guests, colleagues, beloved family members, the ones right here, and also the ones behind their computer. I promised my family to wave, so hi mom, hi dad, hi grandpa. Most importantly, my dear students, good afternoon and welcome to the closing ceremony of the academic period 2014-2016 of UNESCO-IHE Institute for Water Education. When the cortege entered, you heard the song Water No Get Enemy. Probably many of you will have this in their minds when you're in your bed this evening. It's a catchy song. It was performed by lead singer Chidi, backing vocals Nikki, Happiness, and oh, I forgot her name. She's from TU. What was your name again? Seba? Epsiba. And Epsiba. And our world famous musicians, Professor Rovink and Professor Mainet and Moba on the congas. Give them a warm applause again. My dear graduating students, the last few weeks when I was thinking about how to address you during this special occasion, I suddenly saw a comparison with another shiny event, just like this one, the Academy Awards. I see much resemblance there. On the other hand, though, this awarding ceremony is actually even much better. As you might remember, there was a lot to do about the nominees and their ethnicities. Right here, we have the whole world, every single culture you can imagine underneath one rooftop. Isn't that amazing? So let's take a look at this perspective anyways. So what we know is, during that ceremony, there are nominees to present. And of course, several people receive an Oscar. I'm not talking about those nice blue tubes that you will receive in about an hour or so. No, I'm talking about something different. If it were up to me, who would I nominate and who would win the Oscars? Of course, this is about which outstanding accomplishments I have seen from you. You see, it's not just the studies that you fulfilled here. It's much more. So I hereby nominate all of you for taking that big, life-changing step, or we can call it challenge, for everyone. To name a few, some had to leave their family behind, their loved ones, maybe their pregnant wife, the man they just married, or even their newborn baby. So I especially nominate those students who had to make such tough choices to be able to come here. I would call that one the Oscar of Challenge. And there are many more reasons. Another special nomination should go to the people who had to go through extremely rough times and personal hardships while they were here. These 18 and a half months of being here, unfortunately, does not mean that the rest of the world stands still. Some might have lost a parent, a brother, a sister, or a child, and they had to cope with this loss and keep on going. Yes, the world is small nowadays, but distance is then suddenly so far. Indeed, these brave students should definitely get one, I think. Let's give them the Oscar of Life. Then we have the people who have fought and overcome their prejudice. Let's call it the Oscar of Hope. Many start here with a certain idea on how they can or certainly cannot work with people from other cultures. The other is supposedly lazy or talks too much or never says a word, or is dominant, or not open-minded, you name it. The prejudices are right there. But luckily, after a while, many of you stopped pointing and realized that these ideas were not true. I truly hope you can leave those prejudices behind you forever and continue to work on that open mind. Another important Oscar would be the Oscar of caring. Many of you will have experienced here, and you were caught by surprise, that when you really needed someone, others were there for you. The support that I have seen from one student to another, that was just incredible. People found out that they were not alone. Never forget that. You have made friends for life. And finally, to all of you, please take with you the Oscar of faith and trust. Believe in yourself. Do not fear that you cannot do it. You can. Look at how far your perseverance already brought you. Trust that you can teach others what you have been taught here. Use your gained knowledge and these experiences, and use them wisely. You are our new generation of water leaders. The future is yours. Take those Oscars in mind and think of them once in a while. Do not let go on the way back. And if at a time you tend to drift away a bit, lean on the network that you created here. You are part of the UNESCO-IHE alumni now, the UNESCO-IHE family. So let me conclude with the following, and the Oscars of challenge, life, hope, caring, faith and trust go to the batch MSc 2014-2016. They're all yours. Yes. Since we have many things to do this afternoon, I would like to invite Fritz Holzwart, UNESCO-IHE's rector, to the stage to give his opening address for the closing ceremony. Thank you, and enjoy the ceremony to the fullest.
I will not comment on the melody you played at the moment. Graduating Masters of Science family members, excellencies, members of the diplomatic corps, Lord Mayor, representatives of the Dutch government, members of the UNESCO-IHE boards, professors from IHE and our partner universities, colleagues, friends, ladies and gentlemen, and last but not least, I would like to give a special welcome to the president of the International Water Association, Professor Helmut Kreuz from Vienna. Welcome. Welcome to the awarding of the Masters of Science degrees of the 2014 and 2016 batch. Today we gathered in this beautiful old church to honor and celebrate 125 participants from 38 countries for their hard work. But to start with, let me take you back 18 months to October 2014, when you arrived here and a lot of you had problems in this lovely, foggy, and cold Delft. And probably you remember the first day when you were struggling to adapt to the new landscape you now have to operate in for 18 months. Everything was new, unfamiliar, but it was no real choice. You had to become friends with the cold, the rain, and the wind, whether you liked it or not. But suddenly, you had adapted to the Dutch habits, and one of the important is to use a bike as your primary means of transport, but a lot more. And I would like to mention explicit the bridge builders from your country to the Dutch landscape we have in this city. The Dutch families, the initiative Meet the Dutch helped you to arrive in the Netherlands and to arrive in Delft. This is, I think, a real and important initiative, especially in the time we are living at the moment. And there is a second important bridge builder I would like to remind. This is the Student Affairs Office of the Institute, because all the colleagues in the Student Affairs Office are the colleagues, they had been the first contact point when you arrived in the Institute. Also here, I think you got a lot of help, and this is important for, was important for your stay in Delft. Now I can say, dear colleagues, because from now on, we are colleagues. And soon, you will be given your Master of Science degrees. And probably, you will forget the 3,000 hours of hard studying and all what was involved in it, attending lectures, workshops, field trips, reading dozens of papers, surviving in some or the other way, and there were also less sparkling lectures and the hard studying. But at the end, I think it will pay back. And you should never forget that your diploma you will get is a mile marker. It's a measurement of how far you have come. But it doesn't say a thing about how far you can go. So this is important. Your diploma is a calling to use the talents you have nurtured and the knowledge you have gained here to make a contribution. And even if you are enjoying saying, class is over, learning isn't it? Your diploma is a key to open doors of possibilities, not only for yourselves, but also for others. I hope this unique experience, connecting with people from countries around the world in the best spirit of the United Nations, has taught you that water connects and does not divide. Water is a catalyst for cooperation and not a source of conflict. With the new technical knowledge you acquired, you have new responsibilities as well. On your return home, you will be called upon to lead. Never forget that leadership is service. It is working to serve the community for human and societal development and justice. Your contribution to using sound judgment to finding appropriate and sustainable solution based on solid ethical principles and the notion of integrity to key water issues is vital. No less then to sustainability manage one of the world's most scarce resources for the future generations to come. And sustainability of our world depends on water. You will get with your diploma the Water Wisdom book in addition. And there are personal words of wisdom and encouragement from alumni before you. And with the graduation today, you also become part of this community of these 15,000 water professionals they passed through UNESCO-IHE. And you become part also of the larger UNESCO water family. In this regard, I would like to encourage you to contact your National Committee for UNESCO's International Hydrological Program and see how you can best help as well as benefit from the program. Finally, I would like to thank the teaching staff. From lecturers to professors, the great numbers of guest lecturers, academic mentors, partners involved in the joint program, and the dedication in the past 18 months to work towards your success that we all happily witness today. Taking this opportunity, I would also like to thank the Dutch government and the Dutch institutions, the Dutch water sector, for their generous support that made your graduation today possible. In addition to it, let me name two of our important partners and thanking them. It's the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, which helps us to move things forward, to set the basis for the issue to improve sanitation, to ensure access to safe drinking water, and to make clear that the social development goal number 6 can be only properly implemented if you refer to health on one hand side, to poverty alleviation on the other hand side, and some more. So this is, I think, something what is necessary to mention. And I would like to thank also Rotary International, because Rotary International provides scholarships for the Institute and for you, and helps a lot that we are able to move things forward. And there are also other donors, and I know that this is always a pitfall if you start mentioning, but I would like to highlight, these two as a kind of representative for also the others. Let me close with a quote from Joyce DiDonato. She expressed a great opera singer. She expressed in a graduation ceremony a few years ago. She said, "One of the greatest gifts you can give yourself right here, right now, in this single, solitary, monumental moment in your life is to decide without apology to commit to the journey and not to the outcome." And I would like to encourage you that you make a clear commitment to the future journey of your life. Thank you very much. And now I would like to introduce Dr. Flavia Schlegel, Assistant Director General for Natural Sciences of UNESCO. This institute is part of the science sector of UNESCO and a member of the UNESCO water family. Dr. Schlegel's presence today is an expression of her personal commitment to the work of the institute and a clear signal how important this institute for UNESCO is. The floor is yours, Flavia, please.
It makes me feel like dancing, I have to admit. Lord Mayor, Excellencies, representatives of the Dutch government, ambassadors, family members and friends who traveled from far or staying at home, distinguished rector, professors at UNESCO-IHE and other academic institutions, ladies and gentlemen, but most of all, graduating Masters of Science. The future is yours and it lies in your hands. Today is all about you, the graduating students, and I would like to express my sincere congratulations to all of you, students of UNESCO-IHE program 2014 to 2016. The 18 months of this Master of Science course you have completed is very intense, and it requires focus, determination, and commitment. You all have shown yourself capable of this, and now today you should enjoy the fruits of your hard work and feel extremely proud of yourselves. Once more, congratulations. These 2 years are very special for me, because as you started your master's program in October 2014, I started my new job at UNESCO in October 2014. So I share, yes, so I share this very special moment, this very special connection to that October 2014. But obviously, it also reminds me of my own graduation. It's about 30 years ago now, and I can remember all too well the excitement, the crazy times, the hyper energy, the heart beating, obviously, waiting for the final document to prove that now today you are a master of science. And in the end, I made it, just like you have made it all together today. You all worked very hard, and to get this UNESCO-IHE degree, and it is an enormous achievement. And as my parents were very proud, your parents, your loved ones, all your professors and teachers, the lecturers, they can all be immensely proud of you. You accomplished very, very vital studies, cross-disciplinary, related to various fields in water and environment. The ultimate goal is to lay the ground for your future work as water professionals, water managers, and some even water leaders in your home country or home region or around the globe. You want to make an impact. Your accomplishment, which we celebrate today, is essential for change. As UNESCO Assistant Director General for the Natural Sciences, having started in October 2014, we remember, I feel strongly that science, education, and research are key in trying to tackle the global social, environmental, and economic challenges. I attended COP21 in Paris, and last Friday, 22nd of April, very important date as well, in New York at UN, over 170 countries have already signed the Paris Agreement for Climate Change. We know that hugely challenging goals that nations have set themselves can only be achieved if skilled and dedicated experts like all of you are available. Sadly, they are in short supply in most parts of the world, but your graduation has made this deficit a little bit smaller. It is your expertise, together with your passion, together with your dedication, that can bring change. Water is life. I'm a medical doctor by training, and I know that about 90% of our body contains and is only water. So water is life. But then on the other hand, this is easily said, and I won't think that anybody would dispute the fact and the importance of life, but we all together have to get beyond the rhetoric. The pressure on our planet and the people living on this planet, the animals and the plants, they call for change. And as the UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon said, and I quote, there is no planet B. The UN Water Development Report 2016, produced by UNESCO's World Water Assessment Programme, takes up the nexus between water and jobs and underlines direct correlation of sustainable water management and economic development. An estimated 3 out of 4 jobs of the global workforce are heavily or moderately dependent on water. And half of the world's workers, about 1.5 billion people, are employed in water and natural resource-dependent industries like agriculture, fishery, energy, and others. Investments in sound water management can provide the basis for job creation in all sectors. This requires well-trained professionals and highly skilled workforces consisting of engineers, scientists, practitioners. And guess where they are sitting right now? In this beautiful church, in this beautiful town of Delft. We need more researchers, and I'm very happy to see both men and, I greet in particular, all the women today. We need experts to collect data about droughts and flood management, to help farmers develop irrigation technologies, to inform industrial producers about treatment of wasted water. And we need academics to share vital knowledge about water and environment onwards in the regions that should benefit from this the most, so that water professionals in the Global South can apply this to their daily practice. This is where each and every one of you come into play. Each of you graduating today holds the key to the solutions the world needs. Each of you can contribute to the implementation of the 2030 Agenda and the Sustainable Development Goals, particularly of Goal 6 to secure clean water and sanitation for all. Let me take this occasion to thank the Dutch government for generously hosting and providing essential funding to UNESCO-IHE, a UNESCO Category 1 center. UNESCO's gratitude also goes to the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, the Rotary Foundation, as well as many other financial and political contributors, and in particular to UNESCO-IHE Foundation, for joining forces to contribute to an integrated approach, the only way to support progress across the multiple sustainable development goals. UNESCO, together with its educational institute, UNESCO-IHE, is uniquely positioned to support this process. And I'm also deeply indebted and grateful to all people working at UNESCO-IHE, the professors, the academic board at the institute and at partner institutions, all the people working at the institute and devoting their professional life to educating future generations of water experts. Upon coming home after graduation, many of you will return to your former job. Others will perhaps go back and take up a new challenge in a different employment. In both cases, I hope you will use your newly found knowledge and confidence to promote changes in your region to support governance, water governance and management in creating and maintaining livelihoods. While you have finished another chapter in your educational career, please bear in mind the importance of lifelong learning for future development. With all the developing new technologies, research findings, and innovations taking place in all aspects of water management and governance, you cannot afford to let your knowledge stagnate. Fortunately, UNESCO-IHE can assist by providing a range of alternative study methods ranging from online and open access courses to short courses and the graduate professional diploma program. These are all designed to keep water professionals like you skills topped up. You may even find yourself back at the Institute in the future to pursue another degree. Now, you are returning home. The same attributes of focus, determination, and commitment will be required to allow you to apply your knowledge to tackle the particular water-related issues that the region you're going back to is facing. I wish you success in this challenge. Finally, after all these weeks and months of hard work, the moment has come where you can enjoy this memorable day and remember, please remember, the future is yours and in your hands. Be bold and be strong. As Mahatma Gandhi said, and I quote, be the change that you wish to see in the world. And I'd like to conclude, the Oscar goes to you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Schlegel, for your lively words. Right, so what would our very own Academy awarding or academic awarding event be without a surprise interlude? I would like to invite Chidi and Muba back on stage, and together with these two excellent musicians, they will perform a song. It might sound a bit familiar, but it's kind of altered. I think you will really enjoy it. Sit back, relax, and enjoy. Let's give them a loud round of applause.
Just got our education. We know about flood control. Water problems need solutions. Water science for us all. Hey, teacher, thank you for it all. We're the water people, we are answering the call. We're the water people, we are answering the call. We just got our education. One, two, three, go! We just got our education. We know all about flood control. Water problems need solution. Side.
was awesome. I hope you really understood the words. It was not the original text. It was thank you for it all. Thanks a lot for joining in. All right, I would like to ask Fritz back on stage, who will invite the next guest speaker.
First, I'd like to thank for this great change song of Pink Floyd. And I think to put the song in the direction you did, make sure that you are not ending up simply as a brick in the wall. And now I would like to introduce this year's graduation speaker. It's Brian Abogast, Director of Water, Sanitation and Hygiene Program of the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. Brian leads the foundation's effort to bring groundbreaking innovations in sanitation technology and new ways to deliver sanitation products and services to people in the developing world. He was previously serving in, no wonder, in the Microsoft Corporation, and already there you had close links to research and development projects. And therefore, we are really very interested to hear your graduation speech, and I would like to ask you to come on stage. Brian, the floor is yours.
They told me they would have a song for me when I came out on stage, and I was quite worried, but you know, that was great. Dear ad interim rector, members of the academic board of UNESCO-IHE, guest professors, members of the diplomatic corps, mayor of the city of Delft, representatives of UNESCO, the Rotary Foundation, staff of UNESCO-IHE, dear students and PhD fellows, dear guests, family members and friends, and of course, dear graduates and singers of the academic year 2014 to 2016. It's my great honor and pleasure to be here with you today in this historic city and this really, you know, glorious environment with this unique opportunity to provide this graduation address to all of you distinguished grads. I stand here today as a representative of the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, as you heard, where I am honored to lead the team that focuses on achieving the vision of safe and sustainable sanitation for all. Now, I have to admit that I haven't always been a sanitation expert, and in fact, I'm not really all that interested in normal toilets. But I have always been inspired by innovation. And innovation is what I really want to focus on today. My own journey of innovation started at an event much like this, my own graduation from the University of Waterloo in Canada with a Bachelor of Mathematics. We didn't have cool music at my graduation. This is new. A Bachelor of Mathematics, of course, my accomplishment was not nearly as impressive as all of you. I never went back for an advanced degree. So on this front, you're all already way ahead of me. I had accepted my first job with a company of about 1,000 people in the United States that most of my friends had never heard of. That was Microsoft. At the time, I'd never used a PC. But I was inspired by the innovation that I heard that this young enterprise was driving. And I thought that I might learn a lot from being there, you know, for a few years, maybe 3, 4, or 5 years, as the first chapter in my professional life. Well, this chapter wound up lasting over 22 years and involved many roles where I got to work on the first versions of many different products. And I found it remarkably exciting to be a part of teams that were building products and trying to do things that, frankly, nobody had ever tried to do before. And by the time that I left Microsoft in 2010, that company of 1,000 had become a company of 94,000 people. After focusing on the software world and innovation in that realm, the next area that really inspired me was trying to think about how to address the challenges of climate change through innovating in clean tech. And I spent my next 3 years working with very early startup companies who were trying to invent the new low carbon or no carbon economy. And it was fascinating. But you know, all my life, I've been particularly interested in water from both a humanitarian perspective and a geopolitical perspective. At the age of 12 or 13, I remember reading two articles that really had a great impact on me. The first article suggested that the wars of the 21st century would not be fought over oil, that we'd be fought over water. And the second article, which was not really meant to be taken seriously, but it imagined a future where the United States had so poorly managed their water supplies that they chose to invade Canada to access our wealth in fresh water. So you can imagine how that would have made an impression on a young Canadian. Now, it was much later in life that I finally got to really work with an NGO that was focused on water. But they were also focused on sanitation and hygiene. And that's really when I came to understand the incredible challenges we face worldwide in sanitation. So when I had an opportunity to come and join the Gates Foundation's efforts in sanitation, I jumped at it. For the last 3 years, I've been inspired by innovations that really have the potential to be far more impactful than anything I've ever worked on. The potential to eventually save millions, tens of millions, hundreds of millions of lives by dramatically reducing the incidence of diarrhea and horrible diseases like typhoid, dysentery, cholera, and many others. And to deliver to so many people around the world lives with more dignity. So yes, I'm now inspired by innovation in sanitation. And this is why I wanted to focus on this today. You see, innovation covers so much of what we do and what we need to do. The importance of innovation in improving people's lives everywhere. How innovation can move society forward, sometimes far more quickly than one might have imagined. And its role in driving inspiration and hope for all of us. Now, the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation is focused on supporting exactly this kind of innovation. Guided by the belief that every life has equal value, the foundation works to help all people lead healthy and productive lives. Our Global Development Division, where our team sits, aims to identify and fund high-impact solutions that can help hundreds of millions of people lift themselves out of poverty and build better lives. We work closely, everything we do, through partners to develop innovative approaches and to expand existing ones so that they reach the people who are most in need. Well, at the same time, UNESCO-IHE envisions a world in which people manage their water and environmental resources in a sustainable manner, and in which all sectors of society, particularly the poor, can enjoy the benefits of basic services. The mission of the Institute is to contribute to the education and training of professionals, to expand the knowledge base and through research, and to build the capacity of sector organizations, knowledge centers, and other institutions active in the fields of water, sanitation, the environment, and infrastructure in developing countries and countries in transition. So obviously, these two organizations have much in common. And most prominent is the mission to improve the lives of all people through education, research, and innovation. It's been fascinating for me to learn about UNESCO-IHE and your innovative approach in the field of water, sanitation, and development more broadly, and to learn about how you develop, implement, and validate novel solutions that ultimately aim to improve the quality of life around the planet. Here at IHE, you realize that the most challenging water-related problems are not going to be addressed by business as usual. They're going to require out-of-the-box thinking, deep changes in how complex systems work, and inventive and unconventional solutions. They will require the translation of these inventions into innovative products, services, and new approaches and activities, and they'll require those to actually get adopted by the real world, because no innovation has any impact if it doesn't actually get implemented on the ground. They will require innovations that concerning all three pillars of your operations, namely research, education, and capacity development. Your innovations are often of a technological nature, but for them to be adopted, that also has social, economic, environmental, governance, institutional, political, all of these dimensions, and the world needs innovations in all of those. Innovation is not about technology, it's about change. I've been excited to witness the remarkable progress that you graduates have achieved in the relatively short time you've been here in Delft, and how well you link the fundamentals that you learn through your lecture part of your program with the research thesis work. I also very much appreciate the applied nature of the research that's often embedded in the work of the PhD fellows, and research which is focused on addressing real-life problems, and in turn provides innovative solutions of value to society that originate from each of the research themes of UNESCO-IHE. Now, I also really admired the fact that your institute has also developed a number of innovative products concerning education and capacity development itself, and that a common goal of the institute staff is to maximize the uptake of research results to create socioeconomic value, and that this value generation is very high on the institute's agenda. So it was this focus that first attracted the Gates Foundation and our team, the WASH team, to support you in delivering relevant education and research for people living under challenging conditions. In 2011, we committed a sizable grant to support UNESCO-IHE and partners in development of innovations in sanitation for the urban poor in sub-Saharan Africa and Southeast Asia. The grant funds the work of 5 postdoctoral fellows, 20 PhD students, and 60 master's students. And so far, more than 40 scholars had received the master's degree in sanitary engineering, and several more are amongst you today, present here. Now, one of the most remarkable aspects of this project that I've learned about has been the collaboration with 8 other partner organizations who bring an incredible diversity of expertise and experience. And in fact, the faculty of many of these institutions are honored guests here today. These institutions, the Asian Institute of Thailand, of Technology from Thailand, the Federal University of Minas Gerais in Brazil, the Institut Teknologi Bandung from Indonesia, the International Institute of Water and Environmental Engineering from Burkina Faso, the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology from Ghana, the Makerere Institute of Environmental and Natural Resources from Uganda, the University of Cape Town from South Africa, and UNUVALI from Colombia. The incredible breadth of the expertise of the faculty and the experiences on the ground that you bring to this incredible program is immense. And the tremendous job that UNESCO-IHE does in integrating all that talent and collaborating across all these countries and faculties has been really quite an impressive thing for me to see. You know, yesterday I had a chance to see around 20 presentations of the work that students here are driving, as guided by these faculty members. They range from entirely new technologies to changes to existing technologies that would make them significantly more effective, to how to more effectively engage communities in determining what really is needed in terms of product requirements, to business model innovation around understanding what will lead to profitable and thus sustainable approaches to service delivery. And I also learned in these past 2 days about educational innovations that are being driven by the Institute, such as your new graduate professional diploma programs, the new hybrid masters, new books and online courses on fecal sludge management and experimental methods for wastewater treatment. And I'm also very pleased to know that all these materials will be made under this grant are in the public domain and will be shared far and wide. You know, at the Gates Foundation, we recognize the global role of UNESCO-IHE in educating professionals in the water and sanitation sector and the importance of strengthening and building the capacity of this institute so that it might continue to build the capacities of individuals and of other institutions elsewhere around the world. Therefore, the foundation recently entered into yet another partnership with UNESCO-IHE in establishing and facilitating the Global Fecal Sludge E-Learning Alliance and are discussing support for further innovations in course delivery models and course durations. So today I have the honor to address you, 123 graduates from 38 countries, which is amazing, the academic cohort from 2014 to 2016. I'm convinced that each one of you will leave this place as a better person, enlightened, inspired, motivated, passionate, and eager to apply your knowledge and skills that you've acquired during your study. Now, for you graduates, I trust that your learning experience here has been very valuable for yourself, and no doubt you will leverage this experience to bring value to others. I will have no doubt that you will continue the legacy of 15,000 alumni in this institute in admirable fashion, and that as of today, the world water community is richer with you, the new batch of distinguished professionals. Now, the strategy of the Gates Foundation is guided by the great awareness of its founders for the importance of innovation. So the following two quotes from our co-chair, Bill Gates, expressed this very well. First, if you're going to change people's lives, we need another level of innovation. Not just technology innovation, we need system innovation. And second, never before in history has innovation offered promise of so much to so many in so short a time. Now, why is all this so important? Well, you know, while in developed countries, we tend to take our water and sanitation for granted. In most developing countries, huge challenges remain. And in many cases, they're growing. Aquifers are being depleted, surface waters supplies are oversubscribed. Across sub-Saharan Africa and South Asia, where our foundation is most focused, no cities are doing a good job of delivering reliable sanitation and water services to all of their communities, including the poorest. And as the movement from rural to urban areas continues to accelerate, with most settlement happening in informal areas and slums, these challenges just intensify. And then finally, with climate change threatening to impose further stress and uncertainty on our water supplies, cities looking for resilience in face of these changes are having to rethink traditional approaches to waterborne sewerage. So these are tremendous challenges, and I don't actually know how we're going to solve them. But what I'm certain of is that in order to meet these challenges, we are going to need your ingenuity. We're going to need your expertise, you, the graduates of the class of 2014 to 2016. We're going to need your passion, your ideas. We're going to need your innovation. We're going to need you to not accept the status quo, to push for better approaches and better futures. So graduates, well done for your hard work and your perseverance. You are now receiving your immediate rewards in the form of diplomas and degrees, but you also have to look forward to ongoing rewards that come from going out into the world, putting these new talents to work, and witnessing the incredible impact that you're going to have. So thank you for letting me share this day with you. Congratulations and best wishes.
Thank you, Mr. Auerbach. I think you deserve an Oscar too for your beautiful speech. All right. Yeah. I don't actually have them, but. Okay, so now I would like to invite a duo of student representatives, Ms. Ella C. Hombing from Indonesia and Mr. Frederick Magani, who is the former SAB chair. I would like to invite them to the stage to give their address, to share their reflections with the graduating students. Please give them a warm welcome.
Thank you very much. To be honest, we really don't know where exactly to start. But anyway, this is how we are starting. Dear Rector, professors, lecturers, invited guests, beloved family members, friends, colleagues, and of course, graduates of IHE and future alumni, ladies and gentlemen, salam alaikum. We are so happy and glad that you could join us to this event and share this moment of happiness with us. What an amazing journey. It just looks like yesterday when we were busy struggling, trying to exchange the IHE lane coats for some of us which didn't fit. But we can finally say it's a good afternoon, and indeed, it is a good afternoon. We can proudly smile and say,
wow, we made it, guys. Cheers.
But Ella, before we confirm how good the afternoon is, we have not recognized, I think we have not recognized a special group of people.
And who are they, Freddy?
Those who have accidentally walked in thinking that it's a church service. Anyway, let me recognize all of them in the words of the former lector of UNESCO-IHE, as he used to say, and as we say in Africa, all protocols have been observed. To be representing more than 123 MSc graduates from all over 38 nationalities is indeed an honor for both of us, and we will share to you our experiences, thoughts, and visions. We know you all have wonderful ideas as well, but we are quite fortunate and call it also lucky to be given this golden chance to be your voice this afternoon.
Well, to be honest, I was expecting a music when I came to the stage, but it's okay. Okay. Oh, nice. Okay, I will go ahead. When we first entered UNESCO-IHE, we were so excited and enthused on the prospects of what would lie ahead. But in looking back, we now have reason to reflect the importance of this esteemed Global Water Education Institute. The values of education and problem-solving abilities have bestowed upon us. We must also reflect on the architects of the programs and their invaluable contributions. It behoves us to use the knowledge and experience we gain to somehow positively influence the thinking of the people in our countries, our regions, and the world at large, so as to collectively identify themselves with the common goal of sustainably utilizing the resources in our environment. We were filled with excitement and great expectation on October 2014, when we took on to delve with the staff of faith. I remember by the first time I came here with many friends from Indonesia, Heru, Luis, and other friends. We were so amazed by the sceneries in Netherlands. And also we were also surprised by how on time the transportation is. And we are also especially surprised by the changing weather that make us expect more from pursuing our master. It also reminds me again that some of us were so desired to watch the thesis proposal defense even in the very first week of our coming in UNESCO-IHE. We all had dreams because we knew that we would be exposed to an experience so noble. This marked one of the few times in life when one is excited to meet the unknown. Now I can say from my experience, this unknown then clearly was not the international holiday in Europe, as the letter of IHE would tend to stand for.
A wonderful experience, Ella. By being here today, experience has taught us that through working hard and smart, nothing is impossible. To achieve success, it requires belief in oneself, and this would inevitably lead to consistency, persistence, and self-discipline. We also have learned that true friendship is not common, and that we can identify its existence or presence because it will be wrapped in trust and sealed with kindness. UNESCO-IHE is a place upon which our entrance has taught us that the concept of regional integration through our professions is possible. This is where the amalgamation of different people from different places have spawned an unmeasured sense of comradeship. Embracing of diverse culture, so unique, is a proof of what it is to be a global citizen. Most of us love meeting new people, learning what makes them who they are, and in return, what makes us who we are. So unique, but much alike. IHE provide this opportunity like none than other.
So, the diploma that we receive today represents success and achievement, but we must remember more the journey that accompanied this achievement and success, both the heartache and happiness. If we compare our lives to a thesis report, then the diploma itself is gently tucked away in the appendix, while the journey to attain it fills the main pages. This achievement is somehow not merely indicated by the final grade, but mostly by the process that only we, ourselves, know how precious were the effort we have been through in these 18 months. So in the end, the diploma is not about how people examine us, to some numbers, but how we see ourselves succeeding our best. IHE has instilled in us tremendous fire, a passion for life, and a desire to make the world in which we live a better place for everyone.
Talking of our experience, the international field trips, this is where, for the first time, words like good, fun, exciting were used in the same sentence with IHE instead of assignments and presentations. Places of destination were France, Italy, Germany, Belgium, Spain, Portugal, and the United States. In the urban water and sanitation class, where I belong, it was in the World Cup football champions, the Germans. Our mentors, Dr. Martin Mulenga and Ines, made it a bit challenging, but very, very rewarding. From the analysis of the daily water samples after dinner at 10 p.m., to daily interviews with the local journalists with microphones and huge cameras on our faces, and being on the front cover of the local newspapers was quite an experience. Not counting the regular discussions during meals and between breaks among members who will ask such questions to avoid repetitions and maximize time. The experience more or less prepared us in our research works. Despite cultural differences from colors to race, religion to education, financial or political background, a strong bond was formed in each one of us, a strong, lasting friendship that unites us together cannot be measured by the time spent, but deeply rooted with respect, truthfulness, sincerity, concern, and sensitivity to one's feeling. Dear graduates, I must admit that this is one among of the difficult road to travel. And thanks to the Almighty God that we are among of the blessed few who had the courage to go through this route. Jerry Lawrence, the former president of the Republic of Ghana, once said, and I quote, "It is impossible to live without failing at something, unless you live so cautiously that you might as well not have lived at all, in which case you fail by default. Graduates, we choose to live. That's why we made it this far." Ella has a lot on this.
Well, for me, I'm not improving, but I have so many people asking me, like, "Ella, why are you so happy?" And I asked them, and I told them because I'm a happy person. But also besides of that, I also told them because I want to make a brighter day, and also I want to keep smiling face to make a bad day look good. I accept failures, discouragement, obstacles, and detractors. Some people called me the happiest one, but sometimes I also cried. So this up and down life, however, are my drivers that keep me going to achieve bigger goal, although I'm very small and petite. And I'm not as big as Freddy, and I'm not as tall as the Dutch, but I keep on being motivated to prove more and show more my potential to the fullest. To my fellow graduates, there are bigger classroom and research areas out there waiting for us to make a change. The difficulties that we have encountered in our studies in IHE are just tip of an iceberg. Out there is reality, very challenging and really tough. We will be graded by our quickness in making decisions, flexibility in dealing with people, and the practical applications of the concepts we gain from the professors, teachers, and all over the staffs in UNESCO-IHE. As future water leaders, we are expected to make a change in this ever-changing world. Irrespective of the ongoings in life, be wise, because the world needs more wisdom. But if we cannot be the one, then we can learn or even pretend to be someone who is wise and then just behave like they would. We are expected to be of service to our communities and our countries and also the world. Remember, service is the rent you pay for your staying on this planet.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we conclude our speech, we must not forget how we arrived here today, and thanks that must be given. Our experiences in the Student Association Board, together with our colleagues, were so enriching and rewarding. We would like to thank each and every one of you for your cooperation and participation, especially to the chairs and secretaries of the working groups and the class representatives. We are also very grateful to the following: the Rector and Lectorate for the full support in our activities here. We wish to thank, in absentia, the support and cooperation we received from Professor Anders and Stefan. By the way, Professor Stefan was here yesterday, and he wished you a better career in your future ahead. Our professors and guest lecturers for sharing to us your knowledge and experiences, UNESCO-IHE staff and non-teaching staff, the organization that funded our scholarships, Dutch Friends, through Meet the Dutch program. And here, I take the advantage of thanking my Dutch families, Betty, Hetty, Leo, and Josta. They have made our stay very comfortable. and to the International Student Church, the ISC family, for the moral and spiritual support.
And also especially to the social cultural officers in the Student Affairs Department, Arno, Sylvia, Maria, and Mariel. You guys are so wonderful. Thank you so much.
And of course, to our beloved families back home, we love you and miss you a lot. Thank you for being strong and normal despite of our absence. To the Almighty God, Father, we thank you so very much for guiding and protecting us at all times. Lastly, we would like to say, as the future World Water leaders, the relationship we have here, if harnessed to the fullest, will unite a number of countries together and make this earth a better place to live for everyone.
Asante sana, terima kasih, gracias, thank you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you both. You have done a wonderful job. So this year, I received a special request. Since we as social cultural officers have asked quite a lot from this person throughout those 18 and a half months, to give presentations, to help out with the introduction day, get new students around, a lot. But more importantly, because he's a very talented person, I figured it would be an honor for us to follow his request, to say a few words during this ceremony. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome on stage Mr. Karam Abu Shamala from Palestine. Karam, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon, everyone. I came here today with a small message to all my friends who I met during my MSc studies. This period was just unbelievable and my best chapters of my life so far. But this place where the chapter ends, a new one now begins. The time has come for letting go. The hardest part is when you know all of these months when we were here are ending. But I will always remember we have had the time for our lives. Now the page is turned, the stories we will write, and I will not forget the faces left behind. It's hard to walk away from the best of days, but if it has to end, I'm glad you've been my friends in the time of our lives. We are graduating, and we know our lives will be different and new. We are going out into the world, our goals and dreams to pursue. But the thing will never ever change as we go our separate ways, the friends we've made in UNESCO-IHE will be our friends for all our days. The special ties and attachments we've made, those bonds will never be broken. We will continue to feel. We will continue to feel the special bond, though words may not be spoken. So it's not a goodbye, but rather a farewell. I will see you again, of course, one day. Your friendship means a lot to me, and it will never end. We say goodbye for now. We hold on tight to these memories that never die. Thank you, my friends, for all memories and moments we spent together. And I'd like in this stage to thank personal thanks to Rotary Foundation for the sponsorship and the support I've got during my MSc studies. Last but not least, big thanks goes to Ellis and Joost. I hope they are somewhere here. And the Meet the Dutch program for the enjoyable and unforgettable time. Thank you very much.
And the Oscar of the Great Heart goes to Karam. Brilliant. Thank you. Now that you have been inspired by all these speakers, it is time to proceed with the formal part, the diploma awarding ceremony. After over 18 months of hard work, the time has come for your efforts to be recognized, to receive your degree. You'll be standing here on stage and have your personal 5 seconds of fame. Some might take a minute or so, but experience tells that once you have received your degree, your focus tends to float a little. So therefore, I already mentioned this. Please go back to your seats after you have been given your diploma, because there will be many more graduates who will also receive their degree and who also deserve that applause. Once the ceremony is finished, just before the cortege leaves the room, the photographer will take one last photo of all of you and your tubes together, up in the air. After the photographer has finished, the cortege leaves. Then all other guests are welcome to join for refreshments and congratulations. So we will start with the awarding of the environmental science students, but first I need to adjust the stage a bit. Yes. I will not start to sing, don't worry about that. My apologies for standing like this, but of course these are the true VIPs, so my apologies. All right, so I would first like to call the Environmental Science Program Coordinator Edwin Hess on stage, and I also call on stage Professor Thyssen. It should be the perfect photo, huh? Not to put pressure on you or... Okay, so we will start with the EPM specialization. Are you ready for it? Okay, so the first one on stage will be Miss Adeleye from Nigeria. And the next one, Ms. Ibarra León from Colombia. Mr. Dishimwe from Rwanda. Ms. Riwinta from Indonesia. I think the gentleman needs to go down a bit. Ms. Shabana from Pakistan. Miss Sihombing from Indonesia. Mr. Tesema from Ethiopia. Ms. Tuyezere from Rwanda. Ms. Umurerwa from Rwanda. Thank you, Professor Thyssen. Thank you. I now call on stage Professor Irvine. And we will continue with the EST specialization. And first up is Ms. Assefa from Ethiopia. Mr. Harerimana from Rwanda. Mr. Kenea from Ethiopia. Mr. Mizero from Rwanda. Mr. Ms. Mukarunyana from Rwanda. Ms. Musongo from Zambia. Mr. Wagner from Ethiopia. And then the LWM specialization with first Ms. Golfo Gonzalez from Colombia. Ms. Numi from Kenya. And Mr. Were from Uganda. Thank you, Edwin and Professor Irvine. Thank you. So this brings us to the Urban Water Sanitation Program. I would first like to ask the coordinator, Tineke Hoijmans, to the stage. And I also go on stage, Professor Brjanovic. Okay, and the first one up will be Ms. Barrios Hernandez from Costa Rica. Ms. Bustos Soria from Bolivia. Ladies and gentlemen, with distinction, Ms. Saitar Teixeira from Uruguay. Mr. Koch from Uruguay. Ms. Muwata from Kenya. Mr. Navarro Vitanaga from Sri Lanka. Mr. Putra from Indonesia. Ms. Ramadanti from Indonesia. Mr. Taggart from Canada. Then we go to the SE Cali specialization. First up, Mr. Cunha Apati from Uruguay. Thank you. Ms. Garinoni Ardito, from also from Uruguay. And Ms. Menendez Fagalde, also from Uruguay. Then the S.E. Kumasi specialization, first up, Ms. Sitole from Mozambique. Beautiful scarf, huh? We need another one of that scarf, huh? And Mr. Sindoga from Mozambique. Now, before we move on to the WSE specialization, Damir's trying to hold you there, Marcos. And it's just it might be for a particular reason, because we have a short intermezzo. Fritz, would you please come on stage again? Don't be afraid.
Don't worry, not another long speech, but there is a reason to celebrate an important event and an important achievement. UNESCO-IHE Institute for Water Education and partners have joined hands with the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation in an effort to excel postgraduate sanitation education and research with a focus on solution for the urban poor in sub-Saharan Africa and Southeast Asia. And the six-year capacity building and research project was granted in excess to 8 million euro by the foundation and is the largest research and postgraduate education project targeting sanitation for the urban poor that has ever been conducted. Besides the fact that the project includes scholarships of 20 PhD student fellows and 60 master students, every year one outstanding graduate is awarded the prize for the best sanitary engineering master thesis. This year, the prize is presented by the senior program officer of the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, Dr. Roshan Rai Shrestha. The mic is yours, Osh.
Thank you. For the fifth year in a row, it is my privilege to announce the winner of the Best Sanitary Engineering Master Thesis Award. The 2016 award of $5,000 will be used by the students to write a paper based on the thesis and present it at the conference of his and her choice. This year it will be his choice. And the Best Sanitary Engineering Thesis is entitled Effectiveness of the Additives in Stabilization and the Sanitization of the Fecal Sludge in Emergency Situations, written by Mr. Marcos Amos Zinduga from Mozambique. Congratulations, Marcos. Thank you, Dr. Valjord, for giving me the opportunity to announce this award. Thank you, Professor Tamir.
Thank you.
All right, thank you all. That wasn't so scary, wasn't it? All right, thank you, Professor Brdanovic. I now call on stage Professor Kennedy for the WSWSE specialization. Full of surprises, this ceremony. Brilliant. Okay, so now we continue with Mr. Abu Shamala from Palestine. Ms. Adam from Sudan. Mr. Ba from Sierra Leone. Ms. Javi from Sierra Leone. Mr. Kip Kirui from Kenya. Ms. Kochbej from Slovenia. Mr. Lupoja from Tanzania. Mr. Mariancia from Indonesia. Mr. Murera Manzi from Rwanda. He's happy. Ms. Nikube from Zimbabwe. Mr. Uda from Palestine. Ladies and gentlemen, with distinction, Mr. Petricic from Croatia. Mr. Pratama from Indonesia. Mr. Prayogi from Indonesia. Mr. Sianturi from Indonesia. Ms. Twizy Hire from Rwanda. Thank you, Tineke and Professor Kennedy. This brings us to the water management students. I would first like to request Herman Smith. They are really excited. Huh? Herman Smith was the coordinator of the water management program of this batch. And I also call on stage Professor Zevenbergen. And we will start with the WCM specialization. First up is Ms. Hassan from Kyrgyzstan. Mr. Bali Aminu from Nigeria. Yes. That is taking your 5 seconds of fame, huh? Mr. Mercia from Ethiopia. Ms. Phan from Vietnam. Mr. Tadese from Ethiopia. Ms. Ya from Kenya. Thank you, Professor Zevenmeer. And now I call on stage Professor Zwarteveen. And we continue with the WMWM specialization. Correct. Ms. Sitirin from Thailand. And then we continue with the WQM specialization. Mr. Aponte Rivero from Venezuela. The diploma's his. Ms. Go from Brunei.
Happiness all over.
Ms. Izunobi from Nigeria. Ms. Nina Wabazigaba from Rwanda. And then the WRM specialization, Mr. Agustinus from Indonesia. Mr. Amarasinghe from Sri Lanka. Mr. Kahar from Indonesia. Ms. Kiluwasha from Tanzania. Ms. Mavoko Matanda from Zimbabwe. Mr. Miko Miza from Rwanda. Mr. Ramanda from Indonesia. Ladies and gentlemen, with distinction, Mr. Valli from Italy. Mr. Tamero from Ethiopia. Mr. Tran from Vietnam. Thumbs up. Perfect. And the last specialization of WM, WSM. Mr. Agraman Akiyama from Bolivia. Ms. Cabero Ugalde from Bolivia. Then, from Colombia and from Italy, and with distinction, Ms. Gabriela Flamini. Ms. Dube from Zimbabwe. Mr. Hatibu from Tanzania. Mr. Kemendi from Tanzania. Ms. Santos Di Mena from Mozambique. Ms. Sihombing from Indonesia. Ms. Uwineza from Rwanda. Thank you, Professor Zorteveen and Herman. Thank you. So last but not least, we arrive at the awarding of the Water Science and Engineering students, with Mick van der Wegen replacing Johan Reins as the coordinator, and Professor Roelvink, please join me on stage for the first five coastal graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, with distinction, Mr. El Miladi from Egypt. Mr. Prasetyo from Indonesia. Mr. Tahuraman from Indonesia. Ms. Fiona from Mozambique. Thank you, Professor Ruving. Now, will Professor Rana Singha please join me on stage? Mr. Gonaduwaga from Sri Lanka. Best drummer in town, Mr. Gweza from Liberia. Mr. Supriyatna from Indonesia. Thank you, Mick and Professor Rana Singha. Now it is time for the Land and Water Development Group. Would Annelieke and Professor De Freture please join me on stage? First up is Mr. Ayaz from Pakistan. Mr. Bello from Nigeria. Ms. Benti from Ethiopia. Mr. Bere from Eritrea. Ladies and gentlemen, with distinction, Ms. Blatchford from Australia. Mr. Jisa from Benin. Mr. Fibansia from Indonesia. Ms. Gevere from Ethiopia. Mr. Henawan from Indonesia. Mr. Istianto from Indonesia. Ms. Lema from Tanzania. Mr. Ruona from Zimbabwe. And Mr. Wicaksono from Indonesia. All right, thank you, Annelieke and Professor De Freture. Would Alessandro Catapan and Professor Zevenberger, please join me on stage for the rhythm basing group. Mr. Chambanyong from Thailand. Ladies and gentlemen, with distinction, Mr. Desi from Ethiopia. Mr. Gama from Indonesia. And Mr. Muskie from Nepal. Mr. Radityo from Indonesia. Ladies and gentlemen, with distinction, Ms. Shen from Singapore. Thank you, Alessandro and Professor Zevenberger. It would be highly appreciated if the people who are already at the reception area go back into the benches, because there are a few more people to address. Thank you. Would Gerald Corso and Professor Solomartin please join me on stage? Mr. Hidayat from Indonesia. Mr. Islam from Bangladesh. Ms. Mohamed Khair from Sudan. Mr. Ogonor from Nigeria, sorry. Ms. Sia Han from Indonesia. And Ms. Wang from China. Then from the Hohai specialization, Mr. Chen from China. Mr. Kong from China. Ms. Chen from China. And then finally, with distinction, Mr. Sun from China. Thank you, Gerald and Professor Solomartin. Thank you. Then finally, the HWR group. Would Jochen Wenninger and Professor McLean please join me on stage? Okay, there we go. Mr. Oberheisi from Palestine. Mr. Azri from Indonesia. Thumbs up. Ms. Barus from Indonesia. Ladies and gentlemen, with distinction, Ms. Liu from China. Mr. Minka from Ghana. Mr. Oktapiana from Indonesia. Miss, sorry. Mr. Tefera from Ethiopia. All right, thank you, Jochen and Professor McLean. So let me take this opportunity to be the first to offer my sincere congratulations to all of UNESCO-IHE's new alumni. I hope, yes, you can applaud for yourself. Yeah, why not? Go on, go on. Maybe you can respond to each other. Do you remember the ping pong game that we did when you entered? So I hope that you'll remember today as a memorable moment, the ultimate appreciation of these 18 and a half months, and experience it as a definite milestone in your life. Look around you again, and you see you're now former classmates who have had a big part in this 18 months lasting Oscar story. Cherish the memories you share. Never forget those acknowledgements. The Oscar of challenge. The Oscar of life, of hope, of caring, of faith and trust. Continue to learn from your friends professionally and personally, bringing new perspectives to discussions without prejudice, celebrating with them, sharing your ideas, your hopes, your dreams, and your hardships. You see friends from all over the world who supported you and who you will support the rest of your lives. Remember that experience. Remember those Oscar moments. And remember, the future is yours. I would strongly urge that all students take extremely good care of their diplomas, as they cannot be replaced. Please keep them with you or in a safe place. So now we have almost reached the end of today's official program. In a few minutes, you can join us in the first toast here, after which we will all continue with our celebration at UNESCO-IHE. The party starts already at 5:30 with food and drinks, and you can enter the institute to the front door. But before everyone leaves to celebrate his or her personal victory at the reception, don't start floating yet. A few more messages. So first we will take the photo. You just did the rehearsal here, so now we'll do one with the photographer on stage with the tubes held high. And after that, I would like to point out that the procession of the cortege will be the first to leave the room. While they leave, we have Mary Ellen on stage, together with the professors Minette and Ruving, and they will perform Summertime by George Gershwin. Stay around to listen to her lovely voice. But first, the photo. All right, where are those tubes? Yes. I think there are more. So maybe we can get those who are in the back, maybe we can get you up front here so we have a big stash of blue tubes. Ah, that's all right as well. We'll ask you to stay seated for a while. So Mary Ellen, where are you? There she is. All right, let me get the mic here. Please rise for the cortege of professors. Jumping brilliant. Wow. Wasn't that a beautiful ending of this marvelous show? Okay, so if the graduates who are in the benches back there come up front, so then we have a nice picture, which of course you will all receive, huh? Mm-hmm. So it better be good. Ah, the photographer is doing some acrobatics now. So if you come to the front. Your family is really anxious to congratulate you, so we'll make it fast. Yeah, you can come up to the front here. All right, let me see those tubes. Where are they? Woohoo! More up front there, just before the benches? Yes. So it looks like 5,000 new graduates. Yeah. And all to the right. And all to the left. It's like a wave. Yes. Ooh, that was nice. Congratulations and enjoy the rest of this party.